Welcome back to the Member 2 Sport and Wellness Center and the Member 2 Mi'kmaq Nation for the 2024 Nova Scotia Under 15 AAA Hockey Provincial Tournament. I'm Corey LeBlanc, along with you, Nolan Jessen, bringing you all the pictures behind the camera. And we're into our second game of day two of the round robin portion of the tournament, the five-team tournament. Everyone will play everyone once, two games per day. Our opener on Saturday, the Metro Force West Citadels improved the 3-0, pardon me, with a 3-0 victory over the host, Cape Breton Blizzard, who fall to 0-3. This matchup should be a dandy. It's the 1-0-1 Metro Force West Warriors, pardon me, and the 1-1 Quad County Whitecaps, who lost a heartbreaker in overtime yesterday to the Citadels, 4-3 after 5-4, pardon me, after trailing 4-1, rallied to tie it, and then lost in overtime on a winner from Claire Bourgeois. So they're at 1-1, so this is a huge one as teams jockey for position. The top two teams after today's games wrap up the round robin will play tomorrow for the provincial banner at 11 a.m. Atlantic Daylight Time here at the Member 2 Sport Wellness Center. So we're about ready to go. The crowd's into it, fans and faithful for both sides. The Warriors will be in their blue, white, and red. The Whitecaps in their white and teal. So people to look for in this one, Nevaeh Robertson already has 2 goals in the tournament for the Warriors. We'll have a balanced attack, 2 from Charlotte Audain. Of course, the Whitecaps led by the first and fourth leading scorers in the regular season, Summer McLean and Flora Gale McNeil, respectively. McLean with 2 goals so far, McNeil leading the tournament with 4 in her first 2 games, and we're underway in Member 2. Smith over the blue line. Knocked off her stick, Buffett. Smith back to the point, but Rossong will have to regroup here. Just underway, opening seconds. Again, a huge one for both teams as they try to punch their ticket to a provincial championship game. McLean steered aside easily by the starting goaltender for the Warriors. That's Leanna Oliveira. And getting the nod for the Whitecaps once again is Katie Margaret McIntyre. Side of the net, poked free, McNeil. But Oliveira makes another save. So we're underway quickly here in Member 2, just 59 seconds in. Second of our 5 games today. We had 5 yesterday, 2 overtime thrillers. Great competition, and we expect the same here today again in the battle for a provincial banner. Whitecaps in their own zone. Centering pass, they score! Nevaeh Robertson, who's been a scoring star so far for the Warriors, has opened things early at the 1:19 mark. She ended up alone and able in front. Close quarters and rooped it over McIntyre. So an early momentum boost for the Warriors off the stick of Nevaeh Robertson, her 3rd of the tournament. Centering pass, big chance there. Just busy poking that hole. Was Jenna Cleary. Cleary another chance, steered aside easily by Oliveira. Centering pass, all the way back to the point. Wristed on goal, bouncing puck, but there's Robertson. Robertson looking for more. And over the blue line, wrist shot, save, the rebound. And just finishing was Alexis Brown. What a shift for Robertson. Almost had two. Whitecaps now trying to get their footing. Down a goal early. Unable to corral it was Boyle. Warriors keep it in. Shot from the point. And that was deflected and a save by McIntyre on Mackay. Payne with the point shot. Penalty coming up. Leslie gets it in deep. So a chance on the power play now for the Warriors. Tough call there in neutral ice. There were a few bodies and sticks around. But Summer McLean, that's one thing thus far with McLean. She's had tough luck in terms of penalties. That's her third trip to the box so far this weekend. Not only does it put one of your top scorers in the box, but also a top penalty killer, Russ Song. Beaten. Smith juggled it, and that gave the Whitecap captain McInnes a chance to dump it out. Up front on the forecheck on the kill, Flora Gale McNeil showing her versatility. Not only an offensive dynamo, but a key defensive player for Steve Ryan's Whitecaps. McNeil. McInnes now. Bangs it up the boards. Oliveira then dives out to smother it. We're gonna have a call here. Looks like a roughing call. So a 5-on-3 now for 103. Headed to the box for the Whitecaps, Veronica Boyle. Steve Ryan's incensed at that call, 5-on-3. His team now is gonna have to come up big defensively. Already down a goal, but here come the Warriors. Close quarters, still loose, McIntyre. Steered it away. Robertson redirected wide. Battle down low. Gets back to the point. Wrist shot saved by McIntyre. Leslie. Another chance. Another shot. They score. On the second opportunity, Olivia Warford. On the 5-on-3. Scores at the 4:24 mark, 4:26 mark on the power play. She had that chance seconds before and a great save by McIntyre, but she got it back through a screen in between the wickets of McIntyre to make it 2-0 and the Warriors to remain on the power play. Beaton redirects it, but dumped out. This is a huge juncture this game. We're not even 5 minutes in. Couldn't ask for a better start if you're a Warrior fan. Again, it's Warford. Leslie with the assist. They're in looking for more. Still plenty of time on the power play. Buffett muscles it free. Clearing attempt hits a leg. Gibbs will backtrack to play it safely. She's back there on defense with Mackay. in on the forecheck. 15 seconds remaining in the advantage. Gibbs dumps it right back in. That should do it for the second penalty of the 5-on-3. 9:10 remaining. And now 9:06 as Oliveira smothers it. Boyle comes out of the box. 9:05 remaining. It's been feverish early on. Goals from Robertson and Warford, the latter on the power play. It's 2-0 for the Warriors early in this one. And the Warriors have a steady gallop going here so far. Whitecaps haven't been able to, they had a couple early chances on Oliveira. And now into the zone, but Payne cut that off. And it looks like Payne is going to head to the penalty box. She is, for body checking. So a chance now for the Whitecaps here on the power play. Again, they're led by the league's leading scorer this season, Summer McLean, 42 goals and 19 assists for 61 points. And McNeil taking the faceoff, Flora Gale. Already 4 goals in this tournament and 4th in league scoring. There's McLean, a shot! And she missed on the glove side, it's loose! And Oliveira sprawls to smother it. And we'll have a face-off to her right. That big heavy shot of McLean just missed. McInnes puts it in deep. Good strong defensive work there by Warford, who's already scored in this one. Back at her own end. McInnes being harassed. McInnes rolled off her stick, and that allows Warford to dump it back in behind McIntyre. McLean now. She'll wheel and deal. McLean. She gets knocked off the puck. Back the other way, shorthanded, it's Buffett. Her shot deflects wide. Killing valuable time though. Now she'll just kick it around along the board smartly. Midway through the power play. Now McLean. Often yesterday we saw McLean and McNeil basically play the power plays in their entirety. Battle down low. Here's McNeil looking in front. McNeil dangles it. Backhander. Oliveira got a glove on it. It still loops. And now the Warriors dump it out. Whitecaps look to respond. Connolly dumped it in. McLean to the bench. Still loose down low, late in the power play. Whitecaps down a pair, looking to respond here. After 2 quick early goals, there's a shot by Fight Francis McDonald, but Oliveira back to 5 aside. And it's called on the offside in a hair early, it looked like. Was Isabella Sponigal. If you're just joining us here in this one, the Warriors, 2 quick ones early, 1:19. Nevaeh Robertson, and then at 4:26 on the power play, Olivia Warford to make it 2-0. Off the faceoff, knocked down, but unable to take advantage of the turnover was Boyle. And now racing back into her own zone to gather it is Connolly. Spinning, dumped into the zone though by Fife Francis McDonald. It's going to have enough legs for an icing call. 6:05 remaining in the first. Whitecaps come into this one with a win and a loss, an overtime loss to the Citadels. And the Warriors come into this one at 1-0-1. Whitecaps now. They need a spark here, although it's early. They've taken a couple of quick jabs from the Warriors who trail by a pair. Nice breakout here. McDonald ends up with it and it's on the offside. Mackay in a hair early with 5:30. Remain in our first 15-minute period. Just a reminder, the first two periods, 15 minutes apiece. Short break just at the benches between those. And then a full intermission and an ice cleaning before the 20-minute third period. And again, our second game of the day, three more to come after this one. So we'll end up with five yesterday, five today, and the five-team round robin. And when the dust settles this evening, the top two teams will punch their tickets to tomorrow's provincial championship game here at 11 a.m. If you can't make it out to any of the games, oh, a centering pass there by McLean. She got it back to the point. Down low, picked up there by Violet McDonald. She centered it, it's loose. But Oliveira able to smother it. Just to finish that up. If you can't make it out today to any of the games, we still have, again, three more after this one. You can watch it all here on Member 2 Hockey YouTube channel. Same as tomorrow's championship game, but if at all you can get a chance out to see the action, it'll be well worth it as a penalty coming up. Looks like it's going to be beaten from behind for tripping up the Whitecap captain, Danny Ray McInnes. Face off to the right of Oliveira, who's been sharp early. Back to the point. It's McInnes. McNeil, McInnes, wrister from the point. Missed on the glove side. McLean picked it up. Summer McLean. McLean walks out and Oliveira got it. Looked like under her arm and with the blocker and able to smother it. That's the big thing. No juicy rebounds. And another big save. Off the draw. McInnes. Flora Gale, McNeil, McInnes just inside the blue line. McNeil tried to get it into the slot to Cleary. And now McLean will navigate. McLean, McInnes, Rister trying to get someone in front. Got a little high for any sort of deflection, but now McLean. Juggling it and then losing it out to mid-ice was McInnes. Long dump out there, midway through the power play. McInnes. Violet McDonald trying to pick it up. McLean and McNeil are still out there. There's McLean. She could stick handle in a phone booth, McLean. And she got free, but the shot hit a body in front. And now McNeil, Flora Gale. Four goals so far. Dangles it in front. McLean picks it up. Oh, a big glove save by Oliveira. Great work to keep it in here. McLean. Under 3 minutes remaining in the first. 15 seconds on the power play. Shot from the circle. Easy save there for Oliveira. Not sure why Madison McCachran's upset. And now the referees conferring with one of the Whitecaps players, Sean Richards. Again, I'm not sure what happened after Oliveira loved it. It seemed like McCachran was gesturing to the goaltender. 2:52 remaining in the first. Again, the goals from Nevaeh Robertson and Olivia Warford to give the Warriors their 2-0 lead. Now there are two Warriors in the penalty box. Shots on goal, 11-4 for the Whitecaps. And there is another penalty on the board. To number three, Marley Payne. So it's a 5-on-3 here for 14 seconds. Not sure Payne's serving for Oliveira. Again, we'll get the call here from Scott Purdy, the public address announcer. It's in front, backhander. Hit the side of the net, back to 5-on-4. Beaton stays in the play. Poke deep. There's McCachern. Back to the point, finds Connolly. Wrist shot, deflected up into the netting. Good defensive play there by Leslie. So it's Payne with the infraction herself for slashing. So she's still in the box for 1:28. Can the Whitecaps come through with something here? And there's McLean again, it's loose. But once again, Oliveira. At least so far as McLean's number. Again, she's so deft at walking out from those side boards and finding an opportunity to get a shot away. Now off the draw. McLean will come up with it. Logging heavy minutes on the power play. Rister, again Oliveira. She saw that one. There was a screen in front of McDonald, but she was a little off to the side. So again, Oliveira's been the very much the story. 14 stops so far with 2 minutes, 1:59 remaining in the opening period. And now shorthanded into the zone. Spinning away is Buffett, killing valuable time. McLean comes after her. McInnes in a battle. Finally got it up to McLean, back to McInnes. With 35 seconds left in the advantage, McInnes. McNeil, McLean. McLean rolled off her stick. She'll have to play defense. Now Robertson swooped in front, but it rolled off her stick before she could get a shot away. There's a weak backhander, steered aside easily by McIntyre. Final minute of the opening period. Duaro. That shot sailed wide, banged off the backboards. Warford dribbled out the neutral ice, and that'll give a chance to regroup for Richards. Richards with the lead pass. Sponigal couldn't come up with it. Into the zone. Brown. Shot block. Richards comes up with it. Or pardon me, Sponigal. Connolly. Spins away from her attacker. Here comes Sponigal. Sponigal, Shot block. Under 5 seconds remaining. That should do it for our opening period. Shots on goal, DeQuad County Whitecaps 14. The Metro West Forks Warriors 5, but on the scoreboard, on goals by Nevaeh Robertson and Olivia Warford, the Warriors lead 2-0. So again, they're all big in a round robin tournament, but particularly for these clubs. 1-0-1 for the Warriors, 1-1 for the Whitecaps. Trying to keep pace with the Metro West Force Citadels, who won this morning over the host Blizzard 3-0. And they're at 3-0. So these teams again trying to keep pace in our second round robin game of the day. Coming up after this one at 12:30 p.m. it'll be the Blizzard once again wrapping up their tournament, and they'll go up against the Metro East Infernal. And then wrapping up the round robin day, a big clash at 4 p.m. these Warriors and the rival Citadels. And then at 6 p.m. should be a big one as well. Could be mean a place in the final or not between the Inferno and the Whitecaps at 6 p.m. So again, all these games now very meaningful for the teams involved. Certainly the Citadels are in a good spot with their 3-0 mark. Ready to start the second period. Whitecaps again in their white and teal. Warriors in their blue, white, and red, and we're underway here in the second period. Five aside. Warford, one of our goal scorers, puts it ahead. And now here's the captain, Danny Ray McInnes, ahead to McLean. Summer McLean. And she gets taken down. Whitecap bench. And Faithful wanted a call there. McLean trickled through the blue paint. She's certainly been buzzing around, but Oliveira has her number so far. Shot from the point. And Oliveira steered it to the corner. Back to the point, McInnes. And through a bevy of bodies, Oliveira makes the save. So again, the Whitecaps come out shooting as they try to break the scoring seal here against Oliveira. Back to the point. That went wide. On the pinch, keeping it in. Good first shift here for the Whitecaps as they're looking to rally here in the second. Again, Oliveira. So deft of steering that out of harm's way. Again, the pressure continues. McCackern now. Back to the point. Put back in down low. There's Flora Gale McNeil poking at it. Out there with Richards as well. Warriors able to get it out. Now they're on the counterattack. Robertson always off the cage of McIntyre. A good hard shot. Claimed off the mask. Robertson's been dynamic in this one. Already has a goal. Could have another two easily. But McIntyre's come through. Mackay couldn't catch up to that, so it'll be an icy call against the Warriors. 13:02 remaining in the second. Shots on goal at 15-6 for the Whitecaps. Off the faceoff, a scramble. Coming free is Audain. Audain already has a pair so far. Audain in front. McDonald tried to pick it up and get a shot away. There's a shot. McIntyre the save. as she's turned aside Payne. Great rush by Audain. It's been kind of quiet so far. We haven't called. That's the first time I think we've called her name, and she's a threat. And she showed it there. Don't forget we've had the Warriors killing a lot of penalty time as well. It's in front to scramble. And look at Oliveira. Dives face first to smother it. And we'll have another face off to her right. First couple of minutes, all white caps. Other than that chance from Robertson. Back to the point, McInnes. Hit a body in front, went skyward. Warford. McDonald knocked it down. Actually, that's Smith, number nine. Buffett. Buffett. Back to the point, Warford. Point shot blocked. Good work by McLean. She's on the rush. Looking for a feed from Boyle. Centering pass. But McLean was tied up and couldn't get her stick on it. McLean getting the attention of two Warriors. Another save for Oliveira. Banged out the neutral ice. Warriors now looking for a cough up. Still battling. Strong shift for Smith. She wants to get a change. Buffett's been out there for a bit. Shot. Oliveira, that's the first time she's probably juggled one. But able to pounce on it with 10:59 remaining. You almost sense a goal is coming for the Whitecaps. As they've surged here in the opening 4 minutes, but and have 18 shots on goal already, but just can't get one behind Oliveira yet. Wilkie around the boards. Gained it back. Warriors looking to break out, but again, push back in. Now it's Wilkie. Lead pass. That went off the stick of Brown. Brown's out there, back out there with Robertson, along with Sangster. Kept in. Some room for Wilkie. Wilkie on the backhand, and she put it skyward and missed. McNeil, who's been a scoring giant for the Whitecaps. Sharp angle shot there. Oliveira smothered it with 10:05 remaining. Face off in the Warrior zone. Off the draw. Great work there by Payne. Got away from a pair of checkers. Got up the boards now. Trying to squeeze it out, but it's kept in at the point. Oliveira steered it aside. Now chugging is Leslie. Leslie flying in. Oh, and she just missed top shelf. What a rush by Leslie. Split the defenders and then just missed. Glove side against McIntyre. And an icy call here against the Whitecaps with 9:19 remaining. Their coach is their bench, imploring them to keep pushing. We've really done nothing, Aaron. Everything but score here so far, and 19 shots, as we mentioned, on goal. Back to the point. Smith Nadia Smith down low. Buffett redirected a rolling puck in front. Taking over the Whitecaps. Here's McLean. McLean. Wide wrister, and it went wide. Buffett now. Buffett. Tangled up with McLean. Also in the help was Connolly. Below the red line, now a battle. The pinch, but McLean pokes it by. McLean. Saucer passes it. Able to pick it up is Boyle. Weak shot, missed short side. McLean tries to get it deep, but now it's Brown. Brown dropped it off, trying to send Smith away. Now it's Brown. Brown motors in. Gets away from a checker. Wilkie with the point shot. Brown got a piece of it. And we're going to have a penalty call here. I think when Brown was upended, it's going to be Carey Dwerrell, I believe. No, it's going to be the captain of the White Caps, Danny Ray McInnes, to the box. So a big chance here. Really, this period, first 7 minutes, have definitely leaned towards the White Caps. But they haven't been able to get on the scoreboard. Now a chance for the Warriors. Up a pair to extend their lead off the draw, though Connolly up around the boards, but it's put back in deep. Ripped to the blue line, and Leslie brings it out. Warford in over the blue line, but unable to get back out was Brown. So it's called on the offside with 7:43 remaining in the second, 1:42 in the McInnes cross-checking call. Sangster, she'll dump it in, but it's knocked down, still loose, and still in the zone. Picked up Sangster, good save by McIntyre. Put down deep, Brown, back to the point, Warford. A redirect it, and that went into the far corner by Robertson. And dumped all the way down Oliveira, and she'll have to smother it. As forcing the issue there was Sean Richards. So good play there by Richards, forces the faceoff in the Warriors zone. Face off to the right. Of Oliveira. Buffett. In over the blue line. Buffett spins from the checker. Back to the point. Juggling it is Smith, and she lost it into the corner. So a chance for the White Caps. Can't get it out. And now behind the net, back to the point. Smith. Smith battling. 25 seconds left of the power play. Top of the circle, a wrist, a rebound. And a great defensive play there to clear things away. And that was Dwaron, because there was an open net after the initial McIntyre save, and that should do it for the power play, although the Warriors still have control. Sharp angle saved by McIntyre. And that gets by Leslie. No icing. McInnes, fresh out of the box, in helping on the forecheck. And she'll come to the bench. 5:35 remaining in the second period. Steele fight Francis McDonald with good work, tried to center it. And now Audane shakes off a checker, puts it in deep. Great work by Audane. Now Mackay, the taking over of the Whitecaps. Cleary feathers it in. Less than 5 minutes remain in the second. The Warriors 2, the Whitecaps no score. McDonald able to make her way off. Some fresh legs out there up front. Boyle now centered it. Hit a Warrior leg and that allows Mackay to get it out. Here's Robertson. Robertson saved by McIntyre. Robertson has probably been the top offensive threat for the Warriors. She has one of the goals for her team, but she's had three or four more quality chances. Off the draw, back to the point. Squirts out. Put behind the net. Goes out to Brown. Brown bangs it ahead, but no, it's not going to have legs for an icing. Back to collect it is Morrell. Morrell up the boards, trying to get it to Summer McLean, but it's stopped by Warford. 3:30 remaining in the second. Still 2-0. Both goals early in the opening period in the first 5 minutes by the Warriors. Robertson and Warford. McNeil still with it. Battling, trying to barge her way in front. Gets it back. A sliver of room now for McNeil, but getting in there to block, it was Brown. McCackern. Back to the point. Bouncing puck. Still loose. Backhander, Oliveira. Able to make the stop. She turns aside McCackern on the sharp angle backhander. But again, the Whitecaps buzzing again. They'll get a faceoff in the Warrior zone. McDonald in to take it. Back to the point. Another shot block by Buffett this time. So the Warriors strong defensively, especially keeping the lanes clogged in front of Oliveira. And then when she's had a step up, Oliveira has been great. Smith chasing it down. Beaten, juggle it, then get a shot away and a save by McIntyre. Dwaron now. Less than 2 minutes remaining in the second period. A late goal here would be a tremendous tonic for the Whitecaps. What a dogged effort there, making chase with Sponigal. What work, Sponigal, still on it. And she heads to the bench, she's pooped. And deservedly so after that effort. She'll get a well-deserved rest and be right back out there. Now Audane again, here she comes, she scores! Charlotte Audane. Again, she's been fairly quiet, but that's the second time she's taken over. And this time it pays dividends. at the 1346 mark. What an individual effort, her third of the tournament. To make it 3-0, wow, that's a huge one. Really most of the period's been in favor of the Whitecaps. They just haven't scored. And then one coming off the stick of Audain there, who just threw the lip of the crease. Off the stick of Richards. Less than a minute remaining in the second. Warriors 3, Whitecaps no score. We did see the Whitecaps yesterday against the Citadels rally to tie it at 4 with 3 unanswered. So again, unassisted, Charlotte Audain with a great effort in the Warrior faithful cheer that announcement. And deservedly so, just a great individual effort. Now off the draw. Banged out, Brown. Less than 30 seconds remaining. Neutralized Warford, poked it ahead. Now Robertson. Robertson, who's been dynamic. Robertson into the slot, the shot, and it hit the goal post. That close to being 4-0. And Sankster almost potted another. And the horn goes in the second period. Shots on goal after 30 minutes of play. Whitecaps 21. Warriors 13, but on the scoreboard, it's 3-0 for the Warriors. And the Whitecaps will get a chance to regroup. Again, they had a rally in them yesterday. Do they have another today? Don't go too far. Should be a dandy third period here. Remember to. You're watching the 2024 Nova Scotia Under 15 AAA Female Hockey Championships on the Member 2 Hockey YouTube channel. Welcome back to the Member 2 Sport and Wellness Center, the Member 2 Mi'kmaq Nation for the 2024 Nova Scotia Under 15 AAA Female Provincial Championship Tournament. I'm Corey LeBlanc along with you, Nolan Jessam, behind the camera for all the action here on day two of the five-team round robin tournament. We're in our second game of the day, waiting for the start of the third period between the Metro West Force Warriors and the Quad County Whitecaps. The Warriors lead 3-0. Heading to the third period, they had two goals in the opening period. The opening 5 minutes, Nevaeh Robertson and then Olivia Warford on the power play. It stayed like that until 13:46 of the second period on a great individual effort by Charlotte Audain to make it 3-0. And that's where we stay in game to start the third. The teams come into this one. The Warriors 1-0-1, a win and a tie yesterday. The Whitecaps 1-1, the loss, a heartbreaker to the top-seeded Citadels, 5-4 in overtime, and a goal by Claire Bourgeois. And we're ready to go here in the third, and really in the second period particularly, the Whitecaps. Not that shots on goal are indicative of everything, but they do have the edge there, and they've had the lion's share of the quality chances, but they haven't been able to solve Lidiana Oliveira, who's pitching a shutout so far, and her counterpart, Katie Margaret McIntyre, has been solid as well. No chance on any of the goals that beat her. So, a mountain to climb here for the Whitecaps. Can they swell and pour in over the Warriors and get back into this one? We'll start the see right now. And they're gonna drop the puck again. Whitecaps in there, white and teal. Warriors in blue, white, and red. Off the draw, Smith back to her defender and dumped in. That's going to be an early icy call as Rossong tried to start the offense, but she didn't make the connection with any of her mates. So the faceoff will come into the Warrior end of the ice to the right of Liliana Oliveira. Looking for her second, actually a tie in her first game, that thriller with the Inferno, a 3-3 deadlock. McInnes from the point. Knocked the stick out of Smith's hands, but the Warriors get it back. Again, that third goal late by Audain was really huge. Now McLean. McLean knocked off the puck. Again, looking, Whitecap bench looking for a call there. And there was a long discussion between Steve Ryan, his staff, and the officials during the intermission. They really haven't been had, especially early on. That goal by Warford came on a 5-on-3 to make it 2-0. Buffett now. But again, the Whitecaps have certainly had their scoring chances. They just haven't been able to cash in. That no icing on the play. Back to get it, Leslie. Leslie able to get it by McNeil, and now in full stride, but trying to wriggle her way loose is Robertson, who's probably been, along with Audain. The thing with Audain, it's been bang, bang. She had two lovely forays, one ending up in her goal. But maybe from wire to wire, Robertson has been a threat every time out there. And now with 18:24 remaining in the third, still plenty of time, but Whitecaps would certainly love to get one early here. Buzzing around McIntyre now. into the zone. Dump behind the net, rings around the boards. Warriors come free. Banged off the boards. Brown will chase after it. Brown harassing the defender there. Romard. Traffic jam in front of the benches. Not sure what's happening here. As the Whitecaps bench again not happy. There was some confusion on the chains with the officials seeing why the play was blowing down. And again, the Whitecap bench having another discussion with the officials. And Steve Ryan certainly hasn't been very happy throughout this one. So we're getting ready for a draw into the right of McIntyre. And actually, it looks like it's going to end up being too many players on the ice, as much as the Whitecaps argued their point. So a big point here. And don't forget the Whitecaps are dangerous on the penalty kill with the likes of McNeil. Maybe they have some magic there. Good chance this for the Warriors could easily put things away here, 4-0. Beaten. Crowd getting into it here, remember to. Rossong now. Rossong into the slot, Smith! Big shoulder save by McIntyre, the rebound! And she keeps beating that bay. It was blowing down, official lost sight of it. Isabella Sponicle serving the penalty. Face off to the right of McIntyre. McIntyre knows she has to do all she can to not let in any more as her team tries to rally. If they can get this kill, maybe it'll be a spark. In that second period, for a chunk of it, you had the feeling that the Whitecaps were on the cusp of getting one. It just hasn't materialized. Thanks to the Warrior D, particularly Oliveira. Buffett now. 45 seconds remaining in the advantage. Buffett. Crisscrossing. As Beaton heads to the bench. Buffett centered it. Hit the leg of McInnes. And put deep by Smith. Up the boards. Banged out. And now off to the races is Richards. Robertson in over the blue line. Nevaeh Robertson spinning from McLean. Robertson, big save, the rebound. Dane Owen diving was McIntyre to keep it out. Couple of golden chances there for both Robertson and Dane to get their second of the game. But McIntyre hurtling her body to the side to keep it out. Tail end of the power play. Again, could this be a spark and a turning point for the Whitecaps? They're going to have to get the rally caps on here. Down three, now back to even strength, 15:30 remaining. Sponigle to the bench. Payne now, Payne barges in.
Dane.
And over the blue line.
McInnes.
Around the boards. Half wall. McNeil. Florigail McNeil. McInnes.
Warriors not giving Whitecaps much room here with the 3-goal lead. Now McLean with some open ice. Summer McLean. McLean, a wrister, shot block. And then Oliveira comes sprawling out to smother it. She gets a pat on the back from one of her teammates after that play. That was Wilkie. Off the draw. Kept in at the point. Now McInnes. Half wall, McNeil. McNeil, 4 goals in the tournament thus far. They may need her magic here. But Buffett strips her. And now the Warriors a chance to clear the zone. It's out the neutral ice, McInnes. Bouncing puck, Smith. Smith, a wrister, saved by McIntyre. She couldn't control the rebound, but McInnes took over. The captain now dumps it in. Took a bump from Payne. Oh, and then she and Payne go hurtling into the net. And I think it might be McInnes, or is it Payne? I think it's Payne. Although she looked like she took the worst of the ride. She's going to get the interference call impeding McInnes heading to the net. Face off to the right of Oliveira with 13:31 remaining. Chance, Whitecaps really need this one if they're going to make their way back. Dumped to the corner by McInnes. There's where Violet McDonald, Florigail McNeil, McInnes. Back to McNeil, but she fanned on it, but there it is. McNeil in, shoots! And Oliveira. McNeil frustrated. Oliveira, she hit her in the chest. She had some room. And just as importantly, Oliveira smothered the rebound. Great individual effort there by McNeil. Violet McDonald, you think a goal here too would wash away a lot of frustration. The further along they go, the more they think, can we beat Oliveira? But now McNeil spinning like a top and came away free. McNeil. Down low, Violet McDonald. McNeil. McDonald back to the point. Wrist shot, redirected, it's loose. Oliveira down. Oh, and it was banged through the crease. How did that go in? As Oliveira was like a starfish on her back. Another point shot, and Oliveira smothers that one. And then a little chatter after between Wilkie and McLean. Face off to the right of Oliveira. 24 stops thus far. Back to the point. Whitecaps. Point shot, screen in front, but it didn't get through. Now Connolly, sharp angle.
chipped away by Oliveira. Banging away, still lose a big pad save by Oliveira as she robs McHackern. That shot sails by, Moore looking for a deflection, ending another centering pass. And finally, Buffett dumps it out and it's back to five aside. Whitecaps did everything but score. And now the Warriors look to answer. Smith, dipsy doodles. Tried to center it, hit a leg. Got it back. Smith, wrister. Another shot block. And now back the other way come the Whitecaps. Dumped in by Boyle. She wants a change. Full scale change for the Whitecaps. That gives the Warriors a chance, but they cough it up and neutralize. But Smith takes over. Too far for Beaton. But able to keep it in was Blanchard. Bodies foul behind the net. Play on. Beaton lofts it in. She wants a change midway through the third. Warriors 3, Whitecaps no score. McDonald now. Pinned against the boards. There's Robertson. Robertson, the wraparound. It goes through the lip of the crease. That hit the side of the net. Brown tried to stuff it home. She scores. Brown shook off the defender. Burst in front. Her initial shot stopped by McIntyre. But she poked home the rebound to make it 4-0. At the 10-19 mark of the third. Great individual effort by Brown, her first of the tournament. So after the power play, where the Whitecaps did everything but score, a couple of minutes later, Warriors, Alexa Brown unassisted. Again, shook off her defender, walked in front. McIntyre made the initial save, but Brown didn't give up on it and slid home the rebound inside the post. Now with 9:25 remaining. Certainly the enemy now of the Whitecaps, down 4. They had a 3-goal rally yesterday, so one never knows. Now Audane. Audane knocked off her stick by McLean. Audane was hauled down. Warrior faithful wanted a call there. And now the Whitecaps. McLean dumps it in. Took a poke at Beaton. Spun around. Kept in at the point. Bouncing puck. The battle for it there. Squirts loose and here's Beaton. Oh, and Beaton gets slammed and there'll be a penalty on that play. Sean Richards to the box. 8:09 remaining for body checking. A no doubter there. 8:09 remaining. And now the Warriors to a power play. And wow, if they can get one here, that it would pretty much seal the deal. They send out Robertson and Brown. It's in front, Brown, but it was steered away by McIntyre. On that clearing attempt, McInnes hit her own player, McCachran, who come off gingerly. Good work shorthanded here, McNeil and Oliveira. Snatches that one. Oliveira cool and confident. As again, she's still pitching a shutout here with 7:34 remaining. Her team on a power play. Crisply into their zone. Barging in is Robertson. Oh, and a sensational stop by McIntyre to keep it 4-0. Robertson that close to having her second. Katie Margaret McIntyre with another great save. Off the draw. Trying to muscle it out to McNeil on the penalty kill. Still a minute remaining in it. Short side. Great play there, muscling her way in front was Mackay. Down low, Audane. Audane walked in front and put it through the crease. Banged around the boards and out with 30 seconds remaining in the Richards body checking call for the Whitecaps. Warriors don't want to sit back. They don't want to do anything dangerous either with the advantage. Give the Whitecaps life shorthanded. Mackay knocked off her stick. The captain Wilkie. Smith puts it in deep, brings it around the boards, and all the way back to the point to Wilkie. Beaten out in front. They score, it went in. Carly Beaton. Not sure how it got in. Found a crevice between McIntyre and the post. To make it 5-0, that coming at 14:07, Beaton. So barring some sort of offensive explosion here by the Whitecaps, it'd be hard to see 5 goals in 5:44. The way that Oliveira is playing and her defense in front of her. But here come the Whitecaps after again Beaton just made it 5-0. Point shot McInnes, but again smothering it was Oliveira. Unassisted goal for Beaton. .515 remaining. First game of the day for these teams. Warriors will be back on the ice at 4 p.m. in a clash with their rivals, the Citadels. And And then to wrap up the day, the 6 p.m. game, the Whitecaps will be back on the ice against the Metro East Inferno. They're bringing McIntyre to the bench. 6 attackers on. For the Whitecaps, you kind of have to throw caution to the wind here. McLean now. Oliveira's frustrated her, and she's pretty much had a warrior shadow throughout this one. But it will be a power play here. A cross check. So headed to the box for the Warriors is Leslie. And a face-off to the right of Oliveira. Looked like the Whitecaps were calling a timeout, but off the draw. Wrist shot to save, the rebound! And again, Oliveira. She's like a cat with a mouse as she pounced on another rebound before the Whitecaps could get a stick on it. 6-on-4 here with the power play. McInnes now. What the Steve Ryan and his staff have in mind, as well as any sort of goal differential, may come into play. They'd like to at least narrow the gap here. McLean steered wide, laid it back, got it back. McLean, a wrister, though, she went cross ice. The Flora Gale McNeil, but she couldn't get a stick on it. Now McNeil tried to reciprocate and get it to McLean, but that was broken up and cleared the neutral ice midway through the advantage. McCaffrey. And she scores! She caught Oliveira a little flat-footed. So the power play goal. Likely too little too late. So it'll be Madison McCaffrey. Again, seem to fool Oliveira, who got a piece of it. That breaks the shutout. Certainly no, the Warriors aren't worried about that. They're worried about securing the victory. Beaton looking for another. Sharp angle, rebound. Still loose, and finally McIntyre. Able to get her glove over it with 3:20 remaining. So pulling the goaltender worked on that occasion, although it was really off the run of play after. Dribbles in front. McCaffrey. Now Richards. Sean Richards. And in early was McCaffrey, the goal scorer on the far side. So that's called in the offside with 2:59 remaining. Shots on goal 31-25 for the Whitecaps. But again on the scoreboard, 5-1. For the Warriors. Oh, and McNeil with the Michigan
puts it in the top corner to make it 5-2. A great individual effort there. I don't blame McNeil. She's been stymied throughout by Oliveira, so she went into her bag of tricks there to cut it to 5-2. Whitecaps not giving up. Again, if nothing else, those two goals might come in handy. McNeil towards the net. Oh, just unable to get a stick on it was Violet McDonald. Another one shortly, and it gets really interesting. It's loose, and it went through the crease. Now with the empty net, Robertson, and that'll do it. Robertson with her second of the day into the empty net. She opened the scoring back in the first. So two more for her, four in the tournament. And now it's 6-2. Again, and Robertson into the empty net to make it 6-2 unassisted. Whitecaps back pressing. This was a matchup between the fourth place club in the regular season, the Warriors, and the second place Whitecaps. McDonald puts it ahead. Mackay. Mackay with it. Sharp angle. Sail wide. Kept in by Rossong. But out comes the captain, McInnes. Danny Ray McInnes. McInnes looking in front. Tried to stuff it home in the final minute, but Oliveira smothers it with 53.5 seconds remaining. Just a reminder, our next game coming up in our second day of round robin action, 12:30, the host Cape Breton Blizzard, their final game of the tournament, will play the Metro East Inferno. Now beaten, left there for McDonald, and a save by McIntyre. Lead pass, McLean. Deflects. Hits the back glass, still in play. Under 30 seconds remaining. McDonald in a battle, wins it. McDonald one-on-one here. Just keeps it deep, smart work by McDonald. At the end of a shift, now McLean. Lead pass, just able to get a piece of it was McEachern. And that should do it. The Metro West Force Warriors will improve to 2-0-1 as the horn goes. And they congratulate Liliana Oliveira on the victory. And despite the six goals, of course, won the empty net. A strong effort from Katie Margaret McIntyre, as well as the team shake-up, will stay for the player of the game presentations, and then we'll step away for the break between games. Don't forget our next one, 12:30, the 0-3 Cape Breton Blizzard against the 0-1-1 Metro East Inferno. Big game for the Inferno. Blizzard have been eliminated from a chance to play for the championship. But certainly they're not going to mail it in, so it should be a good one here at 12:30. If you can't make it out, we'll have it here for you again on the Member 2
Hockey YouTube channel. Now we'll get the players of the game for this one, 6-2, the final. Danny Ray McInnes, the captain, gets the nod for the Whitecaps. Tough loss. They fell behind early 2-0 and seemed for a lot of the first and a big chunk of the second, did everything but score. And then a big goal late in the second by Audane made it 3-0. That changed the complexion of things. Liliana Oliveira, the player of the game, and deservedly so, lost her shutout, but was sensational. Oliveira gets congratulations from her mates. And we'll step aside now. We'll see you in about 20 minutes here at the Nova Scotia Under 15 AAA Female Hockey Provincials. Coming up, the Blizzard and the Inferno, and you'll see it all on Member 2 Hockey YouTube channel.